Welcome to the Robert Christian Show, Washington's number one LGBTQ news talk show. Progressive talk, celebrity interviews, and issues that matter most to you. Join us now.
Just in case. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Robert Christian Show. We have, I hope, an inspirational show ahead for you. On today's agenda, I have been searching for a piece about this. I've been searching for something to say that perhaps would be words of wisdom or words of comfort. And you all are gonna, you'll get this. Because when I looked at the news yesterday, and then the day before, and I heard the horrific incident that happened in Florida, my heart was struck. And like many of you, saying, there has to be a time and a place that we come together as one and finally stand up and say we've had enough. When a gunman killed 20 first graders and 6 adults with an assault rifle at Sandy Hook Elementary School in 2012. It rattled Newtown, Connecticut, and reverberated all across the world. Since then, there have been at least 239 shootings nationwide. In these episodes, 438 people were shot, 138 were killed. I want to know, when is enough enough? How long is it going to be, ladies and gentlemen, before you, as an individual, wake up, make the declaration that you've had enough? The data used from the Gun Violence Archives, a nonprofit that began tracking school shootings in 2014, about a year after Sandy Hook. Now I want to get to the points. Again, we can surely see the anger, the aggravation, the dismay of people just like you all around the United States. People just like you saying, you know what, there has to be a better way. There is. The problem is that few can understand it. Very few can even say, you know what? We have to press on. We have to elect, we have to vote into office people that aren't sold out to a specific group just because of the love of an AK-47. We're going to vote for this guy. We're going to vote for this woman to represent our cause that aren't sold out to the mayhem of the war machine. It's time to turn it off. Point number one. is this. The guns don't kill people. Although that is correct, at least in theory. But let's finish the statement. People do. Now, what aggravates me is this. If you want to know, you want to know what aggravates me, I'm going to tell you what aggravates me. When it comes to this issue, that too often people don't want to address gun violence in America until after a massive and an event that happens just like what happened in Columbine, just like what happened in Aurora, just like what happened in Newtown, Connecticut, just like what happened in Oregon, just like what has happened in California, just like what happened in the church in Texas. The list goes on and on and on. Just like what happened in South Carolina. Just like what has happened in Chicago. Just like what has happened in Dallas. We live in a society that needs healing. They have been talking today and saying, you know what, it's because of mental health. We've got to take care of the mental health issues in America. Oh, that's great. Let's take care of the mental health issues. Not a problem there. Here's the problem. When the White House and the budgetary restraints have taken money away from states, have taken money away from mental health agencies for health care, and now they're saying, well, we have to focus on mental health, but yet we're gonna take the funding away. Let me go back in time just a few years. Now, I'm not a surgeon. I'm not a historian. But you can look at, don't believe me. You can look it up. And I hope that you do. Back in Ronald Reagan's era, when he was the occupant of Pennsylvania Avenue, there in Washington. And when his budgetary committee decided to defund and to close not one, but many mental health hospitals, and then put a horrible restraint on local mental health professionals and local mental health agencies that deal even in your neighborhood. So suddenly you had people that were thrown out, tossed to the street. And these same individuals were capable of hurting you and your family and your welfare, just like anyone else. But it was a budgetary restraint. It wasn't in the budget back then. But Ronald Reagan's trickle-down economic policy surely was to give the rich a much bigger tax break. The millionaires back then are today's billionaires. And now here we have in recent memory, President Barack Obama, when he was strengthening the mental health field, adding money to mental health agencies, And even so much that he closed a loophole, which would allow which would have prevented people with mental health disorders, including bipolar, schizophrenia, perhaps from owning a weapon. Donald Trump, in his stupidity, absolute ignorance, took it off the books, and he unsigned what was signed. And now what we find is that it blew up in his face. Now this is sad. Now, I don't do this very often, reading comments. Susan said this. Susan said, even though it is tragic, and the sad event was commuted, let's see, and could have been avoided. Yes. Comment. Oh, yeah. That the event was commented, or it could have been avoided. Yeah. Okay. I also see a young man who is empty-eyed, lost, and angry. He should have been given help and or therapy when he lost his parents. We're talking about the shooter in Florida. Most of all of what is of what he is doing, most of all, what is he doing with the AR-15 to begin with? Good point. Ken, you said, in quotation, so many options. Turn the school grounds into a prison-like facility. No guns, no guns in, no guns out. The idea that guns don't kill people is not working. The violent world needs a better system. Sounds harsh, but a controlled entry and exit to schools may be the only option to reduce this type of behavior. Well, Ken, you might be onto something. Again, you need to remember that it was Donald Trump who has said time and time and time and time again that he doesn't want any gun-free zones. No gun-free zones anywhere. That's his plan. That was his promise. That was on the campaign trail. But yet we have guns in schools today. You have knives in schools today. You have drugs in schools today. You have opioids in schools today. You find people driving down the freeway with a gun in their lap today. You find people going to shopping malls with a gun. What are they doing? Is it target practice? Is that what it is? Is that why that the here since Sandy Hook, that the school shootings that have taken place since then have all taken place with an AR-15 in tow? Is that what it is? Right? One gun can do so much damage. But yet, this is being allowed to continue. This behavior is allowed. And our congressmen, our senators, they sit back and they wink about it. Well, they're not worried about it. Why should they be worried about it? They can't vote against their own interest. Or they refuse to vote against their own interest. Ken, I don't like the idea of our schools turning into a prison-like facility. Not as such. But you know what? Just because your neighbor may drink poison doesn't mean that you have to. Just because a few bad guys have guns, it doesn't mean that everybody should have one or should go get one because of the bad guys having one. No, there are more good people, good law-abiding citizens in the United States than there are bad people who possess these guns. So it's time for Americans to wake up, and it's time for people to get their head out of their backside, stop sniffing the glue, and start looking at reality. In reality, it is far better to look at gun control as something that is feasible, as something that is doable, as something that can be done, and then to pressure our lawmakers into making such changes. Am I against the Second Amendment right? No. However, the Second Amendment right was that Americans have the right to bear arms. Oh, yes, but let's continue on. For a well-regulated militia. Now, who are these militias, and how are they regulated? Who is regulating them? These are top-notch questions, if you like it or not. Look, I will ask the hard questions. And at times, maybe the questions are a little bit uncomfortable. That's why I'm progressive. That is why I continue to push forward. That is why I'm always seeking and looking for truth. I'm always looking for a subject on shows that will make people think. I have people that are wanting to be guests on the show. And sometimes I have to wait a little bit. Sometimes I have to wait and see what these people are about first. It's better to know those that work with you, right? Than to have just anybody and everybody with you doing a show with you, and you know nothing about them. So, but when it comes to this issue, I think that what America has become, it has become a very dangerous environment for a lot of people, because no one is immune. I like the European model of gun ownership. You know what? You can own a gun in the UK. Absolutely. It is a privilege to own a gun. It is not a right. Based on the Constitution, the American Constitution, the good old American way of life, which is mandated or dictated by the Constitution. Now, if you are a Republican, if you are, you pay far more attention to the Second Amendment than you do the 25th Amendment. You spend more attention on the Second Amendment than the 3rd or the 4th. The 5th, your attention span is not good for most Republicans, because there is more to America than saying, hey, I own a gun. There is more to living in America and experiencing the freedoms that we have than just saying, I am a Republican, I have a gun, and I have ammo. It's more than that. If we cannot seek freedom, if we cannot seek happiness without arming ourselves to the nines, you know what? You've got a problem. A big problem. Now, I am, like most Americans, in shock over what happened in Florida. And it aggravates me when I see people standing up and only supporting the Second Amendment right. It is our right. It is our obligation. Let me tell you something. And I want you to look into it. Look into the idea, because this is more than just an idea. This is, truth. This is a reality that in America, we have the birthright to own a gun as soon as that we are conceived. Look at the laws, consider them before you give your answer. We have the right before we're even not conceived, but before we're born. Let's word it that way. We have the right then to own a gun. Both of our parents are U.S. citizens. Yay, lovely. And we're born in the U.S. Yay, lovely. According to the Constitution, we have the right to bear arms. Ah, did you? Okay. So that means that you are born with a birthright to own a weapon. But you do not have the right to eat. You don't have the right to be educated. You don't have the right to health care. Oh, my goodness. Now, Robert, there's something wrong here. Of course there is. Of course. You don't have the right to color your hair. You don't have the right to own a car, to drive a car. You don't have the right to do any of these things. No. But do you have the right to own a gun? Yes. That's the American way. And we have to really focus on the Second Amendment. I don't care about the other amendments. I don't care about them. Especially everything, you know, after the 10th Amendment. Get rid of it. We don't need it. You know who said that? Roy Moore did. Who's running for U.S. Senate, as you remember. And here he was. And he goes, you know, of anything, everything beyond the 10th Amendment, get rid of it. We don't need it. It doesn't work. Let me tell you what's not working is the Second Amendment. What isn't working is this, because now if you're going to get mad at me, go ahead. I'm still going to tell you the truth. The reason why it's not working, A, because Congress and the U.S. Senate and A, or B, the U.S. Supreme Court have refused to allow changes to take place to it. In other words, a clearer definition. They have a broad scope definition on the 25th Amendment, do they not? Which that is the impeachment of a president and what is required to impeach him. What the grounds of impeachment are. What the process of impeachment is. With the Second Amendment, it has no such clause. Isn't that a coinkadink? So, I'm not saying reword it. I'm not saying get rid of the Second Amendment. But I'm saying, look at this. There does need to be clarification. We need to look at this as a whole, not as a... And look, don't you dare try to split hairs with me, because you will lose. Folks, you will lose. And social media, I mean, come on. Don't split hairs with me. It's not worth it. You will lose. Look, I'm not your enemy. Right? I'm not. What I do is I put it out there. I put the idea out there. I put the story out there. I put the inspirational moments out there. I put the news out there. I put out there for the world to hear and for the world to see. An idea that perhaps it could change their life. I don't know all of the answers. I'll be the first to tell you that. But what I am is a talk show host. I'm not a politician, although some folks have said I should be. But I'm not a politician. I'm not bought off into politics as a politician. I look at what's going on in our world like anybody else, and I share my idea, my inspiration. I share aha moments and moments of fact and truth, because that's what I seek. Nothing else will do. Absolutely nothing else. So when I look at what's going on when it comes to the Second Amendment, if that is the only amendment that matters, then why don't we get rid of everything else except that? Look, this is not the Wild Wild West anymore. And we do need to have lawmakers who have the comeuppance, right? They have the audacity, they have the balls to stand up and be held counted and say, look, we have to do something better. The American public, they have elected us. They need a clarification. Let's clarify what the Second Amendment is. Let us look at and clarify what a well-regulated militia is. Is it that difficult? I'm asking you, as an American, is it that difficult? Yes or no? To determine by law, not by your idea or my idea, but to determine by law, by the nature of the Constitution, by the nature of the Second Amendment, by the dictionary, what a well-organized, about the militia. Okay, well-organized. okay, well-regulated. Okay. So now let's look at the dictionary of today and find out what it says. And then you go back in time to the year of which that, and don't you tell me that, there wasn't a dictionary back then. You know what? I call BS. You go back and you do some research. This is where you do your homework. For crying out loud, you do, and you find out back then when the Second Amendment was created, what the meaning of that same phrase is, a well-regulated militia. Okay, let's tear this apart just a little bit, shall we please? Now, let's not get into a bunch here, right? Let's look at this objectively. Let's look at this openly and stop looking at it like, oh, it's a Republican thing versus a Democrat. Oh, you don't like guns because you're a Democrat. You don't like it because you're a liberal. You know what? I'm proud to be liberal-minded. At least I'm not stuck in the sand. Look, I am slightly to the left. Slightly to the left. But I see things on both sides of the coin. Yes, at times I do agree with Republicans. At times I agree with Democrats. At other times I agree with Bernie Sanders. But I think that we can all agree with this. That there is a better way. But when will our lawmakers pay attention? I've got to hurry. The mentally ill should not have a gun. Donald Trump rolled back President Barack Obama's gun law preventing the mentally ill from owning one. Did you know that? Donald Trump quietly signed a bill into law on Tuesday, rolling back the Obama-era regulation that made it harder for people with mental illnesses to purchase a gun. Now, case in point with what happened in Florida. Did you know that the young man in Florida that did this, that he had some family issues, he had some psychological issues that needed to be worked through? Contacts were made. But nobody took it, apparently, that seriously. Now comes the argument, should a mental health professional, should a doctor be able to write off and say, oh, no, no, you should not have a gun. Oh, no, no, uh-uh, no siree. If that's the case, then the Second Amendment does not or would not appeal to that person's case, then would it? So, we have to do something about the Second Amendment then. If you're going to look at it solely because of a mental health issue, look, we have a mental health crisis going on in America. Gun or no gun. So let's not be blaming every shooting that happens on American soil from somebody who is mentally deranged. If that's the case, then Custer was crazy. If that is the case, then the war between the North and the South, that was a charade. That was a game. A bunch of crazy people that are out there. No offense. But a bunch of crazy people that were out there battling it out between the North and the South. Is that what it is? You're now going to be blaming or implementing something about mental health into the Second Amendment? Well, first, it's not there. So in order to put it there, you have to change the law. You have to change its structure. You have to bring this up in Congress and the U.S. Senate, move forward, vote on it, and the occupant, in this case, of the White House, would have to agree to it and sign off on it. That is how a bill becomes a law. Yes? Yes. I'm glad you agree. So either way, you know what? I just blew it completely out of the water, didn't I? So your argument about keeping the Second Amendment in the Constitution, by keeping this intact the way that it is, I just blew it right out of the water, and I didn't have a gun to do it with. See? The rule, which was finalized in December, let me go back to this. Added, people receiving Social Security checks for mental illness and people deemed to be unfit to handle their own financial affairs to a national background check database would be added to it. Had the rule fully taken effect, which it did not, President Obama's administration predicted that it would have added about 75,000 names to this database. Barack Obama recommended the now nullified regulation of 2013 in a memo following the mass shooting of Sandy Hook Elementary School, which left 20 first graders and 6 others dead. The measure sought to block some people with severe mental health problems from buying guns. Now I ask you, what's wrong with that? If you are hardcore and you say, well, that's against the Constitution, the Second Amendment right guarantees that you have the right to bear arms, okay? Well, we covered this, that from birth you are legally, according to the Constitution, you are able and you are eligible then to have a weapon. Case in point, why don't hospitals, when you are born, why don't doctors, when you're born, why don't midwives, when you're born, show up with a gun and say, slap you on the butt and say, welcome to America, you are an American. By the way, here's your gun, go have fun. Now you're saying, you know what, this, oh my God. No, I want you to answer the question. What's so difficult about that? This is about the Second Amendment. So you can't have the Second Amendment only for some. What if the Second Amendment, what if it said, you cannot own a gun unless you are a millionaire or a billionaire? Everybody else, including poor folks, you can't have a gun because that's a rich man's toy. Again, I like the European model of gun ownership. Do you think that you can have an AR in England? No. Can you have a handgun, a pistol in England? No. Oh, no. But you surely can have a rifle. Yep, you can have one of those. But guess what? The laws that regulate how that they're owned, what guns are allowed, does that take away their right to bear arms? Let me tell you something. In England, it's not considered a right. It is considered a privilege. So, ladies and gentlemen, there is that one word in the Second Amendment that would definitely change everything. It wouldn't change history, but it would change everything. Is it a right or a privilege? Here is... Lord have mercy. You guys getting this? Here's Mitch McConnell.
I believe the government should focus on keeping firearms out of the hands of criminals and those with mental issues that could cause them to be a threat to our society. The government should not punish or harass law-abiding citizens in the exercise of their Second Amendment rights. Unfortunately, S-649 has the focus entirely backwards. For example, the background check portion of S-649 is Senator Schumer's bill that the Judiciary Committee reported out on a party line basis. The aim of that bill, from its plain terms, could not be more clear. Section 121, the purpose section, provides that the aim of the bill is to require Americans to undergo background checks for, quote, all sales and transfers of firearms, end quote.
Okay, and so that is what Mitch McConnell didn't like. So Mitch McConnell, he is not on board with any constitutional amendment to the Second Amendment. He's not in favor, then, of any further gun control. Perhaps if he was, what happened in Florida would not have happened. Here's Ted Cruz.
When the Second Amendment was drafted, it wasn't about hunting. Hunting is a lot of fun. In Texas, I enjoy hunting. Hunting is great. Target shooting is great fun. Second Amendment is not about target shooting either. The Second Amendment, the reason it is in the Bill of Rights is the Second Amendment reflects the fundamental right of each and every one of us to defend our homes and our families and our children from anyone that would seek to do them harm.
Okay, now we have this. Based on this coming from Ted, let's listen to this again. And let's discuss. Let's listen to this one more time.
When the Second Amendment was drafted, it wasn't about hunting. Hunting is a lot of fun. In Texas, I enjoy hunting. Hunting is great. Target shooting is great fun. Second Amendment is not about target shooting either. The Second Amendment, the reason it is in the Bill of Rights, is the Second Amendment reflects the fundamental right of each and every one of us to defend our homes and our families and our children from anyone that would seek to do them harm.
Okay, wait. But it does not include, Mr. Ted, the right of this Florida shooter that killed 17 people, 17 students, and wounded many others. It didn't give him the right to go and go into that school and shoot up the place because he was mad, because he was angry, because he was let down, because he was mentally deranged. Didn't give him the right to do that. Now, if you're going to nitpick, literally, the Second Amendment right, and its meaning as what you said, you're leaving out quite a bit. I think that in today's society that we really should stop making excuse for this illicit behavior and calling it the norm. It's time to stop doing it. It's time that America wake up, and it's time that we acknowledge that there is a problem. There is a huge problem. And it can be resolved based on this current administration, based on this current Congress and Senate. Chances are nil that it will happen. Will there be another mass shooting in America? Yes. Will more people lose their life because of it? Yes. Will a school be then used as target practice again in the future? Yes. I am upset about it. We need to look at what can be done. Look, we can debate it. We can debate gun laws, regulations, and we can come up with some solutions, perhaps. But it is up to our lawmakers to actually implement it. It is up to them to debate it. It is up to them to make a change to help America and to bring America into a much, much safer environment. And the generations to come, let them be safer than the present. America is better than this. But when our lawmakers refuse to make changes, constitutional changes to such laws to help to limit the use of these weapons, which then in fact would make it a federal crime if somebody used a weapon much like what happened in Florida, perhaps things will change a little bit. There'll be no question. Some states do not require registration. Some states do not require. I mean, anybody can go through and buy a gun, go through the background check, and that's that, if you even do that much. You know, I don't like the idea that people's attitude changes once that they have the almighty power of a gun. I don't like that. As an American, we can show our gratitude to American or to America, not by how many weapons that we have, not hardly, but by the life and the liberty and the pursuit of happiness that we can invest in, that we can move forward with, that we can enjoy. The mark of an American never should be based on his gun, the size of his gun, his pea shooter, his I don't know. But it shouldn't be based on that. The American dream, it is not owning a stockpile of weapons. I'm sorry. Now, again, I'm not against people owning guns. I think it's great. But you know what? There comes a time that we have to look at this objectively and say, you know, we can do better as Americans. If the Second Amendment said that you could only have it at a firing range, you couldn't have it in your home, on your person, in your car, on your motorcycle, you can't have it in your backpack, you can't have it in your fanny pack, you can't have it in your underwear. All right, you guys get it. But you can have it in a firing range. You can lock it up there. Safe and secure, put it in your bank vault. All right? It's not taking away the Second Amendment right from you. Surely not. It is protecting you and protecting your weapon. Simple. But there's a lot of bad guys, and they all have guns. Okay, I can hear it. Okay, come on, Republicans. I can hear it. I can hear this. There's a lot of Republicans that say, well, there's a lot of bad guys that have guns. Yes, there is, at least for now. But if the Constitution was changed to include that, guess what? If you got caught with a gun, which they will get caught with one, what happens? Then it's a federal crime. There would be, of course, a mandated a sentence handed down. The gun then would be destroyed, and that would be one gun off of the street. That could be one AK taken off of the street, and potentially thousands of lives then saved. Are you with me? I think that we can look at gun ownership responsibly. And we can learn an awful lot about it. Folks, again, I'm not against the Second Amendment. I think it's a great thing. It's a great honor to have that right. But it is really a sad day in America where you love your gun just a little bit more than you love your children. You love your gun just a little bit more than you love health care. Oh, you love it a little bit more than you do the right to education. My goodness. You love your gun just a little bit more than you do where you live. And to me, it's sickening. You see, the society that we live in is one that is hurting. It is going through growing pains. We are seeing absolute disgusting, horrific incidents on the news every single day. We have, as of now, we have an idiot in the White House. An idiot that talks about, oh, how sorry that he is, and the prayers and the thoughts going to Florida. But said nothing at all about the gun or guns, but just that he was sorry. Folks, the incident that happened in Florida, much like the incident that happened at Columbine, San Bernardino, Houston, we remember. The incidents that have happened in South Carolina. All of these incidents and all of these things have brought us to our moment right now. So surely, we can learn something from each of these incidents. One thing. That I will tell you. One thing straight up. Is this. That we have the opportunity right now to change the parameter. We have the opportunity right now to look at this not as a Republican, not as a Democrat, but as an American. And first admit, you know what? We have a problem. I want people to understand of anything. The part of solving a problem, it isn't denying it. It's admitting it. When we stand up, when we say, there's a problem. That is the first step. In healing, that is the first step. As progressive that it could become, for ultimate change. We do need a change in America and a change in our culture. But allowing Americans to rob, to steal, to destroy, that's not fair. So, I want to go back to Ted Cruz and his statement as I get ready to wind up today's live show. His statement was and is correct. However, there is more to this statement than what he is not saying. Ted, say it again.
When the Second Amendment was drafted, it wasn't about hunting. Hunting is a lot of fun. In Texas, I enjoy hunting. Hunting is great. Target shooting is great fun. Second Amendment is not about target shooting either. The Second Amendment, the reason it is in the Bill of Rights, is the Second Amendment reflects the fundamental right of each and every one of us to defend our homes and our families and our children from anyone that would seek to do them harm.
Okay, again, I will make the declaration that what happened in Florida was not protecting one's home. It wasn't about protecting life, It was a matter of taking it. So when will America have had enough? What is it going to take for people like you to stand up and say, you know what, this is ridiculous. This is utterly ridiculous. This is something that that should have been fixed a long time ago. This is something that we need answers for. Sad thing is that our governing officials, they don't see it that way. If they did, surely they'll want to see things change. And they would ensure every American that it would. RobertChristianShow.com, the only address that you need. Folks, it has been a fantastic show, I think, today. Yeah, a good one. Okay. Maybe not the best. All right, I've heard it all. First hour, Irina Cohen, David Cohen's wife. What a fantastic opportunity to meet with her. Upcoming, Jordan Goodman. He is a Wall Street financial analyst. Roger Winters is also upcoming. Miss Coco Peru is, we are looking. I don't think that she's quite on the schedule yet. Miss Coco Peru, and a very funny entertainer, very good actor. Love it. It's going to be great. We also have contacts out for other little peeps. So that's going to be a very interesting toss-up. Yes, it is. Oh, boy. Anyway, folks, we have a lot of stuff on our website. So, of course, visit us there. Visit our YouTube channel. Subscribe, like, and subscribe. I don't know what's going on with my lighting fixtures around here. Maybe they're just tired. I don't know. All right, folks. Hey, on behalf of myself and the Robert Christian Show, find somebody and love them. I think that we need a little bit of love. We need a little bit of hey, how you doing going on in our life. Don't you think so? All right, folks. Take care of yourself. We'll see you next time right here on The Robert Christian Show. All right. Well, we're done. And that's that.